So hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. And this is a very small tutorial that I wanted to make for people who actually want to import their virtual environments and they want to use it in PyCharm. So basically there might be a few confusions around, like, if I already have created a virtual environment, then how am I going to use it in PyCharm? Because when I try to create a new project from here, file, and I click on new project, so what happens here is I can just provide the name of the project that I want to create. Let's suppose dummy, and I have to choose a project interpreter. Okay, so let's suppose I can choose like the existing interpreter that I have, or I can create a new interpreter with the name of the project itself. Okay, so let's suppose I don't want to do this. Okay, I don't want to create a new interpreter. Okay, I just want to use the existing one that I've already created. Okay, so let's suppose I have the package or the virtual environment installed in this one, this folder path. So I can go to the folder path that I have installed the virtual environment. So it will be in my desktop, which I already had created the package already. So once you are here, you can just do a ls or a dir. So you can see here my venvpy. Okay, so this is the one that I want to import in my PyCharm. Okay, so this is already created, and if you go inside this my venvcd, or if you want to do a ls, you will find scripts folder here. So if you do a cd scripts and do a dir or ls, you will find the activate. Okay, so if you want to activate this, you just need to do dot slash activate. Okay, and just hit enter, so it will be activated. So if you see this my venvpy, it'll be activated. Okay, so if you want to list out all the packages that it has, you can just do a pip freeze. Okay, so now that you see here, we have listed out all the packages here. Okay, and let's suppose I want to use this in my PyCharm. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go here on PyCharm. Okay, if you see here, we have the PyCharm already opened right now. So let's suppose I want to create a new project here, and I want to use this specific virtual environment, okay, which has already been activated. So if you want to deactivate that, then you can do just deactivate, okay, and it will get deactivated. Okay, don't worry. So if you want to use this, you just need to go here and you just need to click on new project that you want to create. So let's suppose I want to create Superman. So this is the project name that I'm going to give, and I don't want to create a new environment using virtual env. I want to use the existing interpreter. Okay, so if you choose this existing interpreter, there are three dots that you see here. You just need to click on this, okay, and you need to choose virtual environment. So once you've selected a virtual environment, here you will not find anything. Okay, so you just have to click on this one, and you have to iterate to the path that you have already created the virtual environment. So it's on my desktop. There's the username that I have. There's the desktop. I had the virtual environment created here. So I will go inside this. This is the virtual environment folder. You just need to drag it down and go to the script folder. And here you will see a python.exe. Okay, this is the one that you need to import. So once you have selected python.exe, you can just click on OK and just click on OK again. That's it. You don't need to do anything else, and just click create after that. And I'll open it in a new window so that I can see the new project opening in the new window for me. So this is the new project that I have created. Okay, it'll take some time to index all the binaries that we have. So how to detect that you have already imported the virtual environment that I wanted to, or you wanted to, successfully? So when you have this workbench, you just need to go to files and you need to go to settings here. Okay, so here you see project Superman. Okay, there are two things available here, project interpreter and project structure. You need to go to project interpreter, and here you will see all the packages that are installed within the virtual machine, and you can remove or add any package that you want by clicking on the package and clicking on minus. This will uninstall the package, and if suppose you want to install a new one, you just need to click on plus, and you need to find the package that you want to install. Let's suppose I want to install Jinja 2. I can install it, or any package that you want, you can install it from here. Okay, so this is pretty simple, but there are a lot of confusions around this. So I just wanted to make a video on this one, a short one, so that it can help you. Okay, so if it did help you, then please like, share, and subscribe. So I'll meet you in the next one. hopefully soon by tomorrow. Okay, so until then, it's Pytholic signing off.